I'm a pimp. And pimps don't commit suicide.
Richard Kelly has been and remains a director of the cult. From his debut, the passionately loved Donnie Darko, through the little lauded The Box, Kelly has stirred up his acolytes, if not the public writ large. Kelly's penchant for metaphysical spirituality with a dash of melancholy has earned him a reputation among viewers inclined toward his brand of weird. No film represents the schism between public reception and Richard Kelly's ambitions like 2007's Southland Tales. Outrageously out of focus, panned at release, consistently reevaluated by Kelly's disciples, the film, an apocalyptic reading of tea leaves, is frequently cited as an unfinished piece of a larger story.
Let's talk about your film. What's it really about?
There are three graphic novel prequels and hints of connective tissue to Kelly's two other films. The storylines can be counted, but deciphering the many plots would take another video of its own, and we're not here to break down the winding plots of Southland Tales. We are here to talk about Richard Kelly's vision of the future. Crime. Kelly, obsessed with the 24-hour news feed, took all of his angst and projected it into the future. Southland Tales, written in 2005, gets credit for getting so many predictions correct. Let's take a look at the highlights, and a major element about which Kelly was exceedingly correct. In the film, Sarah Michelle Gellar plays Krysta Now. Krysta charts a path from sex worker to reality star with a clear vision of personal success guiding her. This unstoppable force of famous-for-being-famous branding predates the Kardashian-like monolith which rose from the shadows of Paris Hilton's 15 minutes of fame. USIDENT's uber-surveillance of American citizens predated Edward Snowden's proof of the same in 2013. But from their screens we see the world how it is, both in the fictional 2008 and the now. Wildfires in California rage in the background of almost every newscast we see. The news of the day is painted on a canvas of flames.
How did you get a copy of my screenplay?
The film is full of extremist views screaming on every side the same way our news channels work hard to show both sides of every outrageous issue. Most of these elements are just background noise to mass protests and unrest about a contentious election. On a meta level, Southland Tales even predicted the rise of Dwayne "The Rock" Johnson. The film has such an incoherent narrative that noting all of this foresight becomes a game of did Richard Kelly predict it bingo.
This is the way the world ends, not with the Fimper.
But with a bang.
It's fun, even part of the experience of watching the film. However, Dwayne Johnson's weird twinkle fingers and Justin Timberlake singing The Killers doesn't add up to a great film. The pieces of Southland Tales come together to create an abstract, fourth-dimensional, predictive puzzle. The plot may need a 10-part Netflix series to reveal Kelly's true vision, but the film, as it is, stands alone as a towering achievement of foresight. Beyond all of those details, Southland Tales predicted the rise and chaos of social media, while Facebook and Twitter were in their infancies. The overlapping narratives of Southland Tales scream and sing at you. They never stop shifting, and they're all unique to themselves, combining into a noise eerily reminiscent to your Twitter feed. Each character is like a person on Facebook or TikTok, posting their feelings and proclaiming importance into the void. Southland Tales makes its audience the iPhone user, doom scrolling through fun video clips like Justin Timberlake's fantastic dance number before switching gears abruptly to a political argument. Then someone's random thoughts on technology. And then again to natural disaster, unfiltered, and in your eyes. Pull up your favorite social media platform. Scroll through. The plot doesn't make sense, but there is a mood you've crafted with the accounts you've cultivated. Scroll for 2.5 hours. Then, as the power dies, turn it off. This is the experience of watching Southland Tales. It's not a masterpiece, but it is a uniquely 2000s look at the future.
Scientists are saying the future is going to be far more futuristic than they originally predicted.
He is a pimp. And pimps don't commit suicide.